Sing aloud to God our strength. Shout for joy to the God of Jacob. Raise a song. Sound the tambourine, the lyre, and the harp. Would you please go with me to the screen as we sing our first song, Lead Me to Calvary. Dear most gracious Heavenly Father, hear our prayer. You are the Holy One among us. What a mystery our lives seem to us. To you, our lives are no mystery at all. We worry so to live correctly and do the right thing. Why should we worry when you are more than able to give us peace? Why do we not find the peace you have for us when you hold it out for us in the palm of your hand? We act like it would be so difficult to just reach out and take it. Our lives would change. We would be more happy, more secure, more peaceful. But we have so much to hold on to, so much to give up, so much that is our own, too much for many to let go of and just reach out to you. Teach us that what we have from our own hand is not worthy of the gifts that you have for us. Teach us to know that your love for us is worthy of our trust for you. Your peace passes all understanding, and it is your peace we come here this morning to try to understand. Fill us with your love and accept our humble worship. We can't be like you, but help us to try. Help us to be the place where love grows, for it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You may be seated. As we go back to our screen for our responsive reading from Psalm 68, 24 through 26. The Lord said, I will bring again from Bashan. I will bring my people again from the depths of the sea.
We have seen your procession, O Lord, the procession of our God, our King.
The singers went before. The players on instruments followed after. Among them were the maidens playing timbrels.
Bless God in the congregation, the Lord from the foundation.
Amen. Bless the reading of God's word. As we stay on the screen, our praise hymn this morning is Lord of the Dance.
I danced in the morning when the world was begun, and I danced in the moon and the stars and the sun, and I came down from heaven and I danced on the earth. At Bethlehem I had my birth. Dancing wherever you may be, I am the Lord.
Our memory verse, since we're in October, is changed to John 1:1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. John 1:1. Amen. Good morning. It's good to see everyone here this morning. Have a lot going on today and through the month of October. And so here we are. We're winding down on our construction project, but we're winding up on our activities. And so that's good. And it truly is wonderful. I'm going to have a praise of seeing so many kids in church this morning. It's a blessing to see all of you here. We want to welcome all of you that are watching at home. And we welcome you into our sanctuary, and you provide a blessing for us, and we hope and pray that this program provides a blessing for you as well. We have a lot of things that are going on. You know, we're still doing our breakfasts in the morning, and I'm still working with the people on the food boxes, and I haven't heard back from too many people about about the food boxes. Are they interested or that? And so if you are watching at home and you're interested in that, let me know so that I can get you some more information or whatever you need. I know there's some people around here locally that would like to do it. It probably take us a little bit of time to get into it and get people really going into it, but I think it'll turn out to be a good deal. Wow, was it just the other day we had movie night? My goodness. Yeah, we had a good crowd for movie night. That was a lot of fun. And and let's see, okay, puppet program. Our puppets are going to be on the 11th this month. From 11 to 2 on Saturday. So the puppets, look for them on the 11th of October. And then our potluck will be Sunday, October 12th. And then we're going to Cranex after church Sunday, the 19th. And that should be a lot of fun. Everybody, when they go there, has a lot of fun. Last night, we started our Saturday evening praise service. We had a nice group here last night. We're looking to grow, and so if you want to come out and just sing songs and have a nice time on a Saturday evening, we ask you to come out. 6 o'clock. We've changed it this year to and moved it down an hour to 6 o'clock to give you maybe that'll be a better time. Let's see. The next thing is okay. We're going to have I've been calling it not a Halloween party, but somebody said they didn't like the idea that we were calling it a not a Halloween party, so we decided to change it, and we're going to call it a day after Halloween party. So we're going to have a day after Halloween. The Halloween's on a Friday night, and so this will be a Saturday, and so we have a lot of stuff lined up for a day after Halloween party. So you did the potluck, okay. And then Wednesday night, I need to let you know about Wednesday night. As Pants here Wednesday night after football practice, he runs straight over here with the kids, and they do chimes. And Pants looking for some more kids to do chimes on Wednesday night. And they get in here, you get in here, what, about seven, almost seven, quarter to seven, and they practice for about a half an hour or so, and then if they want to, we'll get them a hot dog or something to eat, and they can go. But Wednesday night, about seven. I know that's a little bit late sometimes, but with football practice and everything else going on, that's the earliest that we can do. We tried to make it 6:30, but the coaches won't work with us with that. So, we had a nice little group last Wednesday, but Pam is looking for some more kids to do chimes. So they were ready. You were almost gonna do something today, right? But one of the kids that was in couldn't be here this morning. So think about that Wednesday night chime ringers, and they're getting ready, and so that's gonna be a lot of fun. Anything else that besides our Wednesday night Bible study, we have a great time. We're in John. We just started John, and we're going to go through the book of John in Bible study on Wednesday night. And that's a great place for people to start that don't know a lot about the Bible to go in. John we consider to be the love book of the Bible, and so. It's one of the great places to begin. So then I'll with all of that being said, I'll make sure that the screen that you get my addresses and telephone numbers and everything. You can get in touch with us at cbc.tville@yahoo.com, or you can write me at P.O. Box 41, Titusville 16354. And we're on Highway 408, 4 miles north of Hightown. And I did all of that. And I want to let you know that we do have a bus. If you want to need a bus, you can call Sarah, 827-3275, and she'll get you out for a bus. Our praise service again Saturday at 6 p.m. And if you want to come back and pick us up on for the internet, you can go to www.oraregionlive.com, Or you can go to Community Bible Church and pick us up on Facebook. And that's going to be important today because we're going to have a special thing going on this afternoon. We have two young people who are going to be baptized. We're going over to Meadville, and we're going to video that over there. So it won't be on service, but it will be on our Facebook page soon. So you can pick that up there. And then again, I want to thank Armstrong Cable and the stream for giving us the opportunity to be in your homes this morning. Any other announcements that I missed that I need to make? All right, except for one that I remember now. If you want to get in touch with me, and we're you know, I'm doing less carpentry work out there, so I have more time for counseling. And if you need somebody to wants counseling, please give us a call at 967-3628, 967-3628, or you can write me again on my YouTube Yahoo, the cbc.tville@yahoo.com. Let me I'll correspond with you a little bit, and then we'll work out if you want, or you just give me a call, and we'll set up a counseling for you. If I don't have any other announcements, I'll have my ushers come forward this morning for our tithes and offerings. Will you please rise? Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen. Dear most gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for this offering. And I especially thank you for all our children. I thank you for these two young people and their family. And I ask you to bless them. Lord, and I ask you to bless this offering and each and every giver. Lord, we all have things to give. Our time, our talents, all of that is important. We thank you for watching over us and taking care of us. And we thank you for the lives that we have. We thank you for our church, and we thank you for this community. And Lord, we ask you to make us good stewards of what is in your storehouse so that we may use that to continue to make this a beacon so that all people can know about Jesus Christ, the good news that Jesus Christ came and died for them. That you love each and every person, and that you want us all to come to salvation. All these things I ask and pray in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Do I have any praises this morning? God working miracles and wonders in your life. I mean, I know I have. Go ahead, Sarah.
Really been blessing them and taking care of them
through
this time, and he has made a lot of progress.
So good. All right, good for that. Anyone else this morning? A blessing. I mean, it's a blessing to see so many kids in the church, and all of you guys here, and I'll tell you, it was a really blessing to get that the floor glued down, because. But I'm pleased and happy that that happened as well. Anyone else have a The Bible study is really a blessing. We've been really having some good discussions and talk, and sometimes we don't get very far in that, which may be good for anybody that wants to just come in and jump in, because you know, our Bible studies are set up so that you can come in at any time. I like that so much, that people can come in and feel like, oh gee, I don't want to go there because they're in the middle of this book, or they're in the middle of that, and I didn't get there. But we don't do that here. And so the Bible, we study out of the Bible, and it's always such that people can come in, and we'll get you caught up. I promise. We'll get you caught up. We won't let you go. It won't take you long anyway. So, anyone else this morning, have a blessing, a praise. I'm thankful that we have a place to do our baptism. I'm thankful for the people over at Days Inn in Meadville for being so gracious to us to give us an ark. Isn't it wonderful? Because it's a little cold out to be doing a baptism outside today. So I'm thankful that we have a heated pool, and I really appreciate them over there for being so kind and generous to us. Anyone else have a praise this morning? God working miracles in your life. Yes.
We had a much bigger Sunday school class, and it was really nice.
Yes, that was nice, yes. Uh-huh. That's good to see those smiling faces. Uh-huh. And then I guess there is another praise, but I keep waiting for somebody in that corner to Mom brought the kids to church because I needed two of them to be here early, and she had to go back home and get the dog out of the cow pen. But I heard that they got the dog, right? And so she made it back to church. So that's a praise, isn't it? Praise God for all of those things. Ben, continue to be a praise to see you recover. And we want to see you continue to recover in your life as well.
He's back home. His surgery was successful. There's a picture of on Facebook, a cousin has been born. He was holding the baby, and his father said he wants to keep him. But you know, he looks very sick, but you know, he was well enough to be home and holding the baby.
So okay, Teddy's surgery, second surgery on a stent went well, and he's back home, and we'll continue to keep Teddy in our prayers. His little boy's going through a real tough time. And I know that's really rough. Anyone else this morning have a prayer request? I know we have several that are not here this morning. We want to keep those in prayer as well. Anyone else have a prayer request? Yeah. Grandma R-O-S-E? Rhodes, okay. June, okay. All right.
Part. I have a prayer request that we pray for Polly on her trip tomorrow, that she has a great time over there, and that she comes back home soon.
Yes, Polly's going back to visit her parents back to Indonesia. It's been 10 years, and of course your mom's been here a couple times, and we've been to China and been with her. So it hasn't been that long that she hasn't seen her mom. But she's going back tomorrow morning, early in the morning, and for a month. And so we're gonna miss her. And yeah, we'll pray that she has traveling mercies and. Kathy Moore.
Mm-hmm. And her daughter Debbie. They're both suffering from
All right. Anyone else this morning? All right, let's go to the Lord in prayer. Dear most gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for all that you do for us. We thank you for giving us the ability to come boldly before the throne of grace. We thank you that with our salvation, we become adopted into the kingdom immediately. It's so wonderful to be able to stand before you and call you Abba, Father. For we know that every time we come, we pray for jobs, we pray for housing, we pray for people that you answer our prayers. We know that you've been keeping your hand on Teddy, and we ask you to continue to watch over Teddy and his family and the doctors and those that are providing care for him. Lord, we ask you to be with Cody and her family. Lord, you know we've raised them up on many, many occasions, and her grandmother, and we know that now they are looking for a place to live. And Lord, we ask you to make a place available for them as well. We ask you to be with Grandma Rhodes and June. And Lord, we ask you to be with Polly as she travels, that she will be able to travel over there safely and return safely as well, and that she'll have a wonderful time in Indonesia with her family. We ask you to be with Kathy Moore and Debbie as they struggle with their thyroid and the spots on the lung. Lord, we ask you to be with all of those that are not here this morning, with Tripp and Brittany and Jane, who are at the Special Olympics. We ask you to be with them and give them a good and wonderful time. We thank you for the jobs that you've found for Savannah and for Chris, and we ask you to continue to watch over them as well. Lord, we thank you for watching over Dan and for his recovery, and we ask you to continue to keep your hand upon him. Lord, I especially ask you to keep your hand upon our parents who are raising the children, that in this day and this time, that it's difficult, that the kids have to go to school, and Lord, we just thank you that we live in an area where it's not quite as bad as in other places. Being a parent is an important but awesome responsibility. And we thank you for our parents who feel a need to bring their kids to the church to have a relationship with Jesus Christ, to find salvation, as we will witness in a little bit. Our kids are so important. They are the next generation. They're the ones who will be here in the pulpit and singing the hymns and leading others to you. Lord, we just ask you to continue to keep them in a special place, because they have a special place in our hearts. And we ask you to watch over them. We ask you to be with this country and with those that are struggling. And Lord, with the families that have been going through these terrible problems with ISIS, the beheadings and the slavery and the conversions and all of the stuff that's going on there, Lord, that you will be with this country, with our young men and women who serve this country and keep us free, that you will watch over them and you'll help us to continue to be the nation that you anticipated and desired this nation to be upon its founding. Help us to serve you better, to be a people where love grows, a place where people can walk into the door and feel love all around them. We ask you to help us to be the beacon in this community that reaches out to all of those around, and especially to the lost, to help us spread the gospel of Jesus Christ, to find joy in your arms, and share that joy through all the world. For it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. It's the first of the month, and it's time for communion. And while I have my helpers come forward this morning, I'm going to ask you to think about your lives and your relationship with God. I'm very, very proud and pleased and honored and anything else wonderful to be standing here with two truly wonderful kids who've given their life to the Lord and have asked to be baptized. And so we're going to baptize them this morning, this afternoon rather, over in Meadville. But they're gonna share a little bit with me this morning about their conversion, why they became. I'll pass it over.
I was saved a few years ago at Camp for Kids when I asked Jesus.
Grandma wants to see that face.
I was saved a few years ago at Camp for Kids when I asked Jesus Christ to be my eternal Savior and to come into my heart.
Good job.
A few years ago at Camp for Kids, there was this big speech at one of our campfires. It was all in, anytime, any place. You would be there for God. You would praise Him anytime. Well, I tried that for a couple years, and I kept slipping up. And so here's going to be my one point where I'm going to start, and I don't want to slip up anymore. So this is going to be my clean slate to start.
When I was talking to the kids about their salvation, they told me that they wanted to be all in, which meant that they weren't going to hold anything back. It's one of the things that I have preached before, and I'm pleased to see somebody using the term being all in, because that's what we have to be when we're born again, when we're with Christ. We have to be all in, not partway in, but all in. And I'm really proud of both of you. And I want to tell you, though, that you, since you've been here, you guys and your family have been a blessing to all of us as well. And I know you'll continue to be a blessing. And you'll be a blessing for those around you. For kids and other kids who will watch and watch over and see the lives that you will present to them. And by your life, you will lead other kids to the Lord. So you have an important position, but I also want to tell you, you have an important position as well. Because as the congregation, you have a duty to parent these kids, to be good role models, to be there for them. We all become, so to speak, godparents of our kids, so they know that they're never alone. Ever, that they have a family. That's what the church is all about, bringing us together, close together, making us one, growing us. They're going to help me do communion this morning. And what a special time. You know that Jesus went to the table, probably the last time he sat down at the table with his disciples. And you know, he was thinking about you. And he was thinking about you when he broke the bread and passed it to his disciples, knowing that His body was going to be broken for us. Did you know that your name was on His heart when He sat there? And that you're the reason that He couldn't change doing what He needed to do, because your salvation was so important to Him that He would go to the cross and do anything for you. So he broke the bread and he passed it to his disciples, knowing that for each of you as well, his body would be broken. Dear most gracious Heavenly Father, I thank you so much for our congregation, and I thank you for our young people, and I thank you for these two and their mother who has prayed for them to this come to this point. You loved us so much. This is the body of Christ broken for us. After Jesus passed the bread, he knew that not only having his body broken for us, but that his blood had to be shed for our salvation. For without the remission, without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. Not only did he have to be beaten, but he had to be beaten so that he shed his blood for us. Did you know that the Romans kept lots of records? And do you know the Roman record book said that they beat Jesus more than they had ever beaten anybody? I mean, this was the 10th or the 11th legion who had been in Gaul and been around the world. Tough group. Had never beaten anybody that bad. Had never whipped anybody that much and had him survive. But they did. So that he hung in there so that he could fulfill the prophecies to come to the cross, to be raised up. The most gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for that, your sacrifice to give your only Son so that we may have salvation. We thank you for his sacrifice on the cross. Jesus said, do this often in remembrance of him. And then they sang a song.
Wonderful day, day I will never forget. After I wandered in darkness away, Jesus, my Savior, I met. Oh, what a tender, compassionate friend, he met the need of my heart. Shadows dispelling with joy, I am telling, he made all the darkness depart.
Heaven came down in glory,
filled my soul, when at the cross my Savior made me whole, my sins were washed away, and my night was turned to day. Heaven came down in glory, filled my soul. Spirit with life from above, into God's family divine, justified fully through Calvary's love, oh what a standing is mine. And the transaction so quick he was made, when as a sinner I came, took the offer of grace he did proffer, he saved me, oh praise his dear name.
My scripture this morning is from Luke 15, 1 through 10. And I know I have 4 through 10 up there. I'm going to preach about 4 through 10, but I'm going to read 1 through 10. Then drew near unto him all the publicans and sinners for to hear him. And the Pharisees and scribes murmured, saying, this man receiveth sinners and eateth with them. Now I have to tell you, I have to stop right there, because every time I get to that, it reminds me of a story, of a precious little story of a little girl back in the 1800s who was what we would have called a street urchin in London. And it was cold. You know, London, it rains, and it was a winter's day, and it was cold and foggy and nasty, and she decided to go into the church to find a place to get warm. They were having services that night, and so she went in to get warm, and she sat at the pew. And the pastor was had preached from this sermon, or scripture, and she went in, and after the service the congregation had gone, she approached her minister, or the minister, and she said, "Sir, I never knew that my name was in the Bible." And the minister looked at her and said, "Oh, goodness, what's your name?" And she said, "Well, my name is Edith." And the minister looked at her and smiled and said, "Your name isn't in the Bible." And the little girl said, "Well, you just read that Jesus receives sinners and eateth with them." He dropped to his knees, because certainly our Lord receives and received Edith and Andy and Addie and Austin and Sarah and Polly and Jane and Linda and Jean and everyone else that's here, and Mary and John and all the rest of us. And thank God he does receive sinners. What man of you, having 100 sheep, if he lose one of them, doth not leave the 99 in the wilderness and go after that which is lost until he find it? And when he hath found it, he layeth it on his shoulders rejoicing. And when he cometh home, he calleth together his friends and neighbors, saying unto them, "Rejoice with me, for I have found my sheep which was lost. I say unto you that likewise joy shall be in heaven over one sinner that repenteth, more than over 99 just persons which need no repentance." Either that woman having 10 pieces of silver, if she lose one piece, doth not light a candle and sweep the house and seek diligently till she find it? And when she hath found it, she calleth her friends and her neighbors together, rejoicing, saying, "Rejoice with me, for I have found the peace which I had lost." Likewise, I say unto you, there is joy in the presence of the angels of God over one sinner that repenteth. Where would we be without love? Now, in this wonderful parable, we see the first picture, that of the lost sheep. And he spake this parable unto them, saying, the shepherd in this parable is the great shepherd, Jesus Christ. We are the sheep. He had 100 sheep, and one of them got lost. Frankly, for most farmers, that would be a pretty good record if he got to market with 99. But this shepherd, however, would not be satisfied with just 99 sheep. When one sheep got lost, he went out and looked for it. When he found it, he put it on his shoulders, the place of strength, which is to say, he is able to save to the uttermost. The high priest of the children of Israel wore an ephod. On the shoulder of the ephod were 2 stones. On them were engraved the names of the 12 tribes, 6 tribes on one stone and 6 on the other. The high priest carried the children of Israel on his shoulders. Our great high priest carries us on his shoulders, and we will not become lost. When he starts out with 100 sheep, he will come through with 100 sheep, not 99. This is a picture of our Lord Jesus Christ out looking for those who are his own. The second picture is that of the lost coin. The coin was probably part of the row of coins which formed the headpiece signifying the state of a married woman. To lose a part of it was like losing a stone out of one's wedding ring. The woman depicts the Holy Spirit, whose ministry is to make sure that each one who belongs to the bridegroom will be present at the wedding. Every coin will be in place. Everyone is valuable. We are here today not only to worship our God and our Lord and to take communion, but also to be a living part of this very real and living parable. Jesus wants us to know that everyone is valuable. He also wants us to know that everyone who belongs to him is and will be safe. Recently, I've been watching some older Star Trek episodes. There is a common theme that runs through them. When one of their guys gets lost or stolen or into trouble, they always and instinctively know the captain will turn the ship around, ceaselessly scan the entire quadrant, power up the phaser banks, arm the torpedoes, and recover them. We like that because we like thinking that no matter what, someone with power loves us enough to come rescue us, even if we are the ones who did wrong. Well, you see, we have the same attitude demonstrated by our God and our Lord and the Holy Spirit. As a matter of fact, maybe that attitude, that moral directive was brought into the world right here in these parables. A mother prays for her children. God hears and answers those prayers. As witnessed before you in those two young people today, the sheep are hers. They were lost. The mother knows it, and she earnestly prays. She knows God is strong enough to be able to save them, so she prays. She knows that our Lord's shoulders are strong enough to provide protection, so she prays. She knows that every sheep is valuable to our Lord, so she prays. So when the sheep are found, she knows she can be happy because her sheep are no longer lost, but on the shoulder of our Lord. They are no longer her sheep, but they are his. And they are on his shoulders, where she is also. She knows they will forever be safe with him for all eternity. For she knows that is where she finds her shelter, her strength, and her protection. For she is safe in those arms as well. Jesus wants us clearly to know the value of each and every soul. It is such a joy and pleasure to be with young people who have decided to follow Jesus. They have chosen to be all in. Not halfway or partway, but all in. And being all in is the new direction for their lives. I want you always to know you are loved. And you are important, and that you will always belong to our Lord Jesus Christ. I don't care how many Star Trek episodes you see, how much you think's going on, but if the Lord needs to, he'll scan the quadrant, arm the phasers, load the torpedoes, and turn the ship around, and come back just for one lost sheep, even you. So I want you to know that you are always loved, and you are important, and you will always belong to our Lord Jesus Christ. And someone may say, how could you possibly know that? And I know that because that is also a promise of strength that comes from the Bible. And it comes from Romans, and it's right here. Paul teaches us this. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. See, you made that step forward to accept Jesus Christ. You decided to follow Jesus. And Jesus put you in the palm of God's hands. And you can't be removed from there, no matter what. Isn't that a wonderful promise? To know that if we give our lives to the Lord, he will give his life for us. Not only that he has given his life for us, but that he will give it all for us. And that he has everything already arranged and taken care of for us, because He sent the Holy Spirit to make sure that we don't get lost, that we'll be there for the wedding feast of the bride. Can you imagine what that's going to be like when we're called up to heaven and we come, we're ushered in to heaven with a grand celebration to be presented to our Lord. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present nor things to come, nor height nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Such a special promise. Paul builds this thing. It's a bubble around us. You can never be lost again. And you will always, always be loved. Our hymn this morning is Victory in Jesus. Because that's what you have. You have victory in Jesus.
Streets of gold.